ready, Ellie? Here we go.
During the second week of the 2021-22 school year, Matamidi Superintendent Barb Dufferin showed us around Wildwood Elementary, one of four schools in the district.
The first week, I wasn't here because I wanted our teachers to get into their routines, but yes, I do come in here regularly.
Like many other districts in the state, masks are required. It's one of several safety protocols, including physical distancing and regular ventilation system checks. The school board voted to continue, given the high degree of transmission in the area.
I think the thing we all agree on is that we want our kids in person, full time, 5 days a week. That's what everyone wants. And where there might be disagreement on what it looks like, I think overall, what we want is what we have right here in terms of everyone being together.
Matamidi, which ranks within the top 5% of all districts in Minnesota, wasn't immune from the challenges that came with COVID.
I see that you are off to an awesome start of typing your passport.
Teachers and students struggled with hybrid and distance learning, but Dufferin says they adapted and evolved, which is important in a district that values technological innovation.
I've been hearing it since I was hired here and even before, that innovation is a really important core value in our community, and technology is a really important part of that innovation.
Last year, the district provided an iPad or Chromebook to each of the approximately 3,200 students through the Device for Every Learner program.
Now press sign in. Let's save it.
And the technology levy in place since 2002 is up for renewal this November.
There is no designated funding source from the state for technology, so I know that this is a community that has valued technology over the years. We've had this technology levy in place for a long time, and we're asking simply for a renewal of that so we can continue.
In the 4 years Dufferin has been superintendent, she says the district has worked to stabilize the budget as well as determine future needs through a strategic planning process.
What's next for us? Who we want to be next? Where we want to go, what our mission is, recommitting to that. And so those things have driven a lot of our work. That strategic plan in particular has driven a lot of our work going forward, and we're looking forward to refocusing on that now that we're moving through the pandemic and things are getting back to a little more normalcy for us.